Welcome back, learners. Hope you all are doing good. This video will provide descriptive informations of electron microscopy. We already made microscopy related videos. Please have a look if you are interested. Now you can find us at Facebook and Instagram too. We put daily biology related posts, microscopic images and many more. So let's learn. In this video, we are going to discuss few points. The first one is principal features of electron microscope comparing with light microscope. And the next will be spatial preparation of biological specimen in case of electron microscopy. And the third one is the basic types of electron microscopy and the differences between them. Electron microscopes consist of a tall hollow cylindrical column through which the electron beam passes. The top of the column contains the cathode, a tungsten wire filament that is heated to provide a source of electrons. Electrons are accelerated as a fine beam by the high voltage applied between the cathode and anode. A beam of negatively charged electrons can be focused by electromagnetic lenses, and the strength of the magnets is controlled by the current provided them. Air is pumped out the column, producing a vacuum through which the electrons travel. If the air were not removed, electrons would be prematurely scattered by collision with air molecules. As in light microscopy, the specimen is usually stained, in this case with electron dense material. Some of the electrons passing through the specimen are scattered by structures stained with the electron dense material. The remainder are focused to form an image which can be observed on a phosphorescent screen, either on photographic plate or with a high resolution digital camera. The fundamental principles of electron microscopy are similar to those of light microscopy. The relationship between the limit of resolution and the wavelength of the illuminating radiation hold true for both a beam of light or a beam of electrons. So due to short wavelength of electrons, the resolving power of the electron microscope is very high. So we can put a difference between light and electron microscopes between those kind of features which are already discussed in my previous videos. If you can check those, you could easily understand the basic differences between this kind of microscopes. So the first feature I put here is highest practical magnification, and these are the data. So with an accelerating voltage of this kind of wavelength of an electron is 0.004 nanometer, and in theory of resolution of such a microscope should be amount 0.002 nanometer, which is this much time that of the light microscope. Resolution of light microscope is 0.2 micrometer, whereas the electron microscope stands for 0.5 nanometer resolution. The radiation source is visible light in case of light microscope, obviously, and the electron beam is used in electron microscopes. The medium of travel is air in light microscopes, and the high vacuum is very much needed for electron microscopes. The lens is used as glass in case of light microscopes, and electromagnets are used in electron microscopes. So the source of contrast is differential light absorption, and the scattering of electrons are used as the source of contrast in electron microscopy. The specimens are mounted by glass slide, and the metal grid is used, usually the copper one is used in electron microscopes. Since the specimen is exposed to a very high vacuum in the electron microscope, living tissue is usually killed and preserved by fixation, first with glutaraldehyde, which covalently cross-links protein molecules to their neighbors, and then with osmium tetroxide, which binds to and stabilizes lipid bilayers as well as proteins. The fixed tissues normally have to be cut into extremely thin sections, and this is achieved by dehydrating the specimen and permeating it with monomeric resin that polymerizes to form a solid block of plastic. And this block is then cut with a fine glass or a diamond knife on a spatial microtome. Contrast in the electron microscope depends on the atomic number of the atom in the specimen, and the higher the atomic number is, the more the electrons are scattered, and then the greater the contrast. As biological tissues are composed of atoms of very low atomic number, they are usually impregnated with the salts of heavy metals such as uranium, lead. For example, lipids tend to stain darkly after osmium fixation and revealing the location of the cell membrane. It views the surface of specimens, and specimens is fixed, dried and coated with a thin layer of a heavy metal such as gold or a mixture of gold and palladium. The specimen is then scanned with a very narrow beam of electrons, and molecules in the specimen are excited and then release secondary electrons that are captured by a detector and generating an image of the specimen's surface. Areas which generate large numbers of secondary electrons will appear brighter than areas that generate fewer secondary electrons. The image produced appears three-dimensional in scanning electron microscopes. In case of transmission electron microscope, a condenser lens focuses the electron beam onto the specimen and electrons are transmitted through the specimen. The portion of the beam absorbed by the specimen is minimal. To be absorbed, an electron must lose all its energy to the specimen. Image formation in the electron microscope depends on differential scattering of electrons by parts of the specimen. Consider a beam of electrons focused on a screen, and if no specimen were present in the column, the screen would be evenly illuminated by the beam of electrons, producing an image that is uniformly bright. By contrast, if a specimen is placed in the path of the beam, some of the electrons strike the specimen and are scattered away. When the electrons come in contact with the sample, it can either be scattered elastically, that is without any loss of energy, or inelastically, that is transferring some of that energy to the atom. Interaction between the incoming first electron and an atomic nucleus gives rise to an elastic scattering. An interaction between the first electron and atomic electrons results in an elastic scattering. Specimen prepared for TEM has fairly uniform thickness. Therefore, almost no contrast arises from the thickness, and their atomic number also remains approximately constant, so that overall contrast is very low and the specimen appears featureless in the TEM. Here we can conclude the differences between both of these types. In case of SEM, the electron beam scan over surface of sample, and based on scattered electrons, sample can be any thickness and mounted on an aluminium stub. And in case of TIM, the electron beam passes through thin sample based on transmitted electrons. Especially prepared thin samples are supported on TEM grids. Specimen in SEM stage in the chamber at the bottom of the column, and specimens in TIM stage halfway down the column, and the image in SEM shown on TV monitor, while the TEM image shown on fluorescent screen. The image in case of SEM is of surface of the sample, that is three-dimensional, and image is a two-dimensional projection of the sample in case of TEM. The resolution is 2 nanometer average, while the TEM resolution is 10 nanometer of average. The depth of the field is very high, while the moderate depth is seen in case of TEM. The magnifying powers are much more than SEM in case of TEM. And the specimen contrast is by electron consumption in case of scanning electron microscopy, and the transmission electron microscopy, the specimen contrast is by electron scattering. And the field of view is very large, and the field of view is limited in case of transmission electron microscopy. This is all about today's class. Thank you for your patience. I strictly followed these two books for constructing this tutorial. Please go through for better understanding. And if you like this video, do not forget to like, share and comment for any suggestions.